Bombardier brought to the market the fastest executive jet in the world since the late Concorde. Today, Bombardier is the civilian aircraft manufacturer that is closer to the supersonic speed, with an executive jet that will have its first delivery in 2025. The need or eagerness for moving faster brought the humanity to revolutionize on how it locomotes from A to B. Sometimes technology, safety and regulatory hurdles makes impossible to maintain the fastest solution, bringing its existence to be possible only inside the history books and museums. Bombardier found its way to bring civilians a bit closer to supersonic speed through its new aircraft, the Global 8000. Introduced at eBay's show in Geneva by Bombardier CEO Eric Martel, the manufacturer presented the Global 8000 as an evolution from its flagship, the Global 7500 jet, an aircraft renowned all over the globe by its great performance.
Let's start the countdown to our big announcement.
Eric said that the customers wanted a range of 8,000 nautical miles, which is 300 more than the current flagship. They wanted to have the same spacious, luxurious and comfortable cabin, which counts with 4 living space totally customizable, and a better pressurization of 2,500 feet when flying at 41,000 feet, the best available in the market today. The new aircraft not only meets customer requirements, but as a Bombardier says, it raises the bar also for the top speed that now reaches Mach 0.94 from Mach 0.925 in the Global 7500. The CEO confirmed during the Global 8000 introduction that the aircraft prototype broke the sound barrier of Mach 1 multiple times during its preliminary tests campaign in California.
Our test aircraft repeatedly broke the sound barrier. A NASA chase airplane confirmed it. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, we achieved a supersonic flight. How amazing is that?
Such achievement represents the effort to bring the aircraft into its design limits in order to validate it and define the safest high speed and range for normal operations without posing risks to everyone on board. Such kind of tests are controlled and performed by every aircraft manufacturer with professional test pilots. The achievement proved that the Global 8000 is capable of achieving supersonic flights without damaging the structures and the engines. However, the aircraft was not designed to maintain Mach 1. For that, it would be required a completely new airplane from its structure until the engine. On a normal operational case, a Mach 1 shall never be achieved by the pilots, with the exception of an emergency descent. Another remarkable milestone of this test campaign was that the flight was performed using sustainable fuel, making the Global 8000 the first transport category to fly supersonic using this type of fuel. At the test video published by Bombardier, it's possible to see the Global 8000 wingtip shivering in what seems to be when it achieved Mach 1.
There's the Mach. I can feel it. Definitely went Mach 1 there.
Bombardier wings are known by its reduced size, sleekness and flexibility, helping on high performance and delivering comfort at the same time. Eric Martel announced that, from 2025, Bombardier Global 7500 owners will be able to retrofit its aircraft to the Global 8000 version. Bombardier's new flagship introduction and breakthroughs might represent the beginning of new certified super speed and super range aircrafts to come. Bombardier's competitor and also renowned aircraft manufacturers Dassault and Goulfstream are working on the certification for their next generation aircraft, the Falcon 10X and the G800 respectively, which according to the manufacturers, they might achieve Mach 0.925 and a range of 8,000 nautical miles, similar range of the Global 8000. Furthermore, a new supersonic aircraft for commercial flight, which will be truly capable of supersonic cruising speed at Concorde's level, is currently under development and already have its first customer. If you'd like to know more about it, consider to subscribe. A new video about it will come soon.